Alright, there you go, it's an awkward angle. Awkward angle, but I'm doing this for you to see the boat, and there is a goose behind me, you see that? So, hey, what a good photographer! What's your name? Yes, I'm, can I take a look at your camera? That's like a, come on, no, this is a hussy?
Yeah. Look at this, you got an iPhone.
That is not iPhone, it's a Samsung. Hey, come, I'm a photographer. Let's talk. Let's talk about... No, that's not. I got the photography here. Come on, come on. I've been shooting people, but now I'm gonna shoot landscapes. Look at him, look at him. You're too famous? What's your name?
Andy.
Andy?
Yes.
Andy Warhol?
Yeah.
Huh? Ivan, my name is...
I was Warhol.
I'm Ivan. What do you shoot with this?
Whatever I see and interests me.
I see. You're the real deal, I can see. Good. How long?
Kid like you,
I'm like older than you, come on, you just have the beard. How old are you?
I'll be 60. Sure.
60? Wow, you look like 40. I'm 43. Hey, you have a business card?
Actually, I just changed bags and I don't have any with me.
What's your name?
So, Andrew.
Andrew who?
Cohen.
Andrew Cohen, the famous one.
Oh,
I got you finally. Andrew Cohen. Now I'm recording this, so I'm gonna check you on the web.
Okay.
Andrew, how's it going? What did you do today? What did you shot today?
Well, I gotta look at the film. I don't remember. No, I document, I've just been walking around.
Right? I see.
That's...
What about life?
Great.
What about life?
Am I? Life.
What about life? You're the guy to talk about life, come on.
It's worth living.
It's worth living. Good.
What do you do?
I was just about to record a video to ask a question. I ask a question every day.
Of yourself?
No.
Of
myself. Like, fuck them, you know.
Everything needs an audience.
Yes. Well, I don't need the audience, but I'm asking the questions anyway. The question today is, who's Tim Ferris?
Who's Tim Ferris?
Do you know this guy, Tim Ferris? You know what he did to me? You don't know him? You better check him out. This guy stole all my material. While I was sleeping, he came in my mind, dropped every bits of information that I got. 10 years.
Sleeping.
10 years ago he did that, not like today, 10 years ago, and he put it in, not only he taught his friends, but he put it in internet everywhere. So now, I'm messed up.
Now
I gotta do something different. He stole all my material. This guy, he stole all my material, he put it out there, he talked to his friends, he taught all the internet. Now I can do nothing, you know, I gotta do something different.
Can
I was thinking.
Sleep at night with that experience?
I cannot sleep at night at all. I slept 2 hours and every day 2 hours only. Now I'm thinking how to reinvent my photography because I'm suffering in that area too. I show you. Like what? Look. Busy schmizzy. Busy schmizzy. Oh my god. Oh. Tim Ferriss, you gotta check this motherfucker. I'm telling you.
Who's Tim Ferriss?
Who's this? Who's Tim Ferris? Who's Tim? Look what I got. Look what I got. I'm a Canon guy. Oh my god, Vision 6040. What do you make of that? I switched from Mamiya to Canon to Sony and to Nikon. Now.
No, that's a nice camera.
That's a good one. That's not bad. Not bad.
Shooting, you're looking at a video more than looking at the viewfinder. It's more video, no?
I don't know
not
yet.
Capturing, but when you're looking.
Am I recording you?
Like
yeah, that's my boy. That's my guy. What you can teach me in photography? Talk to me. Let's do a talk. Fuck this Ferris guy. The Tim Ferris guy, you're gonna check it for yourself, but.
Tim Ferris.
Let's talk about photography, man. Fuck him. You know,
okay.
Come over. We're gonna.
I can't get down there, bro. Do it on a bench.
Oh my goodness! You can't get.
Down, took me a long time to get back.
All right, let's talk about photography. Fuck the guy. He stole my material anyway. So we're gonna talk like real talk. Real talk photography. Don't steal my bike. You see my bike, motherfuckers? Now let's talk about photography here. I get one guy, photographer, and school guy.
So what are you shooting with the...
What I was shooting, let me see what I shot. Fuck. I shoot, you know what I try to do? You know this guy, Lick, Peter Lick. You should know the guy.
Rick, I don't pay attention.
You don't pay attention? You're the real shit then. You don't pay attention to the...
I'm too busy doing my own work.
That's the best thing. I'm trying to do the same thing. Mm-hmm. Am I on record? Yes. We, you know what?
So what was the question you were going to work on before
I was asking the question, who's Tim Ferris? You know, that was the question. You don't know Tim Ferris, right? You're too busy doing your own thing.
Why would I know Tim Ferris?
Yes, why would you know him? He's a popular guy. You should check him out. I'm not gonna tell you who he is because I'm very jealous, you know. What I was shooting, I bought this camera because prior to that I had Canon system, and I thought that I want to switch from people photography to landscapes, you know. And I was considering cameras.
What do you mean switch? Why are you doing both?
That's a good question. That's like a switch. Very good. No, I mean like
from one frame to the next, you switch. Well, we're not doing frames anymore.
That's a
I'm
real
a film guy.
That's
so
a real
frames.
Talk. That's a real photography talk. No, I was like, fuck this word. Like, I was like, you know, how to avoid this word. Like, I start seeing more the beauty of the world, you know, and. I say I'm gonna get this mirrorless camera. Somebody suggested, you know, somebody put an idea in my head. And I got fed up with film for a long time because it's, you know, you're a film guy, so it's a tedious process.
I can shoot both.
It's better, yeah, it's better. But I say, let me get some shortcut, get this mirrorless camera and take whatever. Lost, I took like...
And you're happy with the quality of that?
Well, not...
That's the latest model? No,
that is the...
New model every day.
Yeah, that is the... This is the 7R. It's not
7R.
Like... Yeah, it's 36 megapixels.
The 2 or the...
This is some in between. But I bought this one because it was... I found a good deal. I was like cheap ass, so... And then... I bought a lens. Oh, good lens to recommend to you. Maybe you know this lens. You're the real guy, so. Yeah, I bought this lens. Look at this. What do you say?
Mm-hmm.
Lens. What do you say about this lens?
I've not used it.
You don't know?
And I really haven't looked at examples of
That's like
what
a,
has been shot with it, so I have no opinion.
They say it's a. They say it's a video. This is a video lens for video, and there is like a way to put it in this camera, wide angle, mm-hmm. 14 millimeters. I find it very pleasing.
That's the E mount.
That's the E mount. Yes, yeah. They
you
did it.
An adapter for
yeah, I can share my experience about the adapter. I bought like the adapter. It didn't work well. You know, it wasn't well enough for me.
Yeah,
I was. Having problems, and that's it. So, mm-hmm. I took a bunch of pictures, like 30,000 pictures, and I put them on a hard drive, and I messed it up. I lost it all.
30,000 pictures in how long a time period?
In 2 months. 2 months. I was. Wow. I've been like walking around, taking mm-hmm. pictures, taking pictures. Mm-hmm. Every day, like I took, I don't know, a lot. Shooting Brooklyn.
Let's see your website.
I don't have a website. You know?
So what are you doing with the 30,000 pictures?
I lost them. That's like.
You lost them.
I lost them. So now I'm gonna have to get Dropbox. I have to get all these digital.
In your dream, you lost them.
No, for real. This was for real.
Just checking between you.
This was for real.
You didn't back them up? You didn't take them off the... No. That's the thing, you gotta back them up.
No, I gotta point at me and I have to say, some people are stupid.
No, technology, that's the problem. It's not perfected.
I wanna ask you, what is the best way to keep data, to keep the files, from coming from experienced guy?
Back it up. You gotta back it up.
Oh, shit. I always do that.
Because drives, external drives, they don't last forever.
Two drives, so I put them in two computers.
At least two drives.
I put them in two computers and in two drives, and everything failed. Like a miracle. Everything fell at the same moment. The hard drives messed up, USB, little portable, like a big one. The computer broke up, everything. So now
at
I have to...
At the same time.
At the same time. It's like...
Well, was it all in a flood at the same time?
Stupid. This guy.
Make sure you're pointing at you.
Okay,
that thing is wandering.
No, it's not this guy. It's this guy. This guy. This is the stupid guy.
Although I'm not the most brilliant.
Yeah. Say something about you. Let's talk about photography. What's the best insight you can give to any photographer, a new jack or experienced or whatever? What do you make out of?
Well, I think you have to develop an eye.
An eye.
The way you like to see something.
How long does
it
take?
How
long does it take to develop an eye?
Well, it depends on how serious you are, because if you look at your work and you think about your work rather than just shooting.
You got a review.
Then you develop an eye.
I mean, you got a review.
You can decide what you like about an image, what you don't like about it. Next time you're out shooting, you have that already in your mind. You improve on the way you're shooting, and your eye is developed.
Good.
So, you don't have to take every picture. If something's not working in the shot,
don't do it.
Don't take it.
Take five rather than 30,000.
Well, I'd rather have five good ones than have to go through 30,000 pictures.
Bullshit.
I mean, that's a lot of editing.
That's stupid.
That's a lot of editing.
That's stupid.
No, it's not stupid. It's just, you know, it's the way it is with digital these
days.
You're not held back, so you do an awful lot of shooting.
Which one is better, digital or film? What's your personal preferences?
Oh, show me a great image in digital. I love it. Show me a great image in film.
No, I don't.
It's a personal preference. I'm crazy about that. You know, a new model coming out every year, and then you know the manufacturers make it so that the latest software, then won't read the old cameras and. It just becomes, whereas my cameras, I've had this body for over 35 years, and I've never done any work on it.
It's no upgrades.
It works exactly the same, not a
always work up, always at work
all,
perfect.
At all. Totally, manual. There's,
totally good.
There's not a light meter in it. There's nothing.
Pure awesomeness.
Nothing. I mean, that's why there are a lot more photographers these days. You don't have to think so much. You know, with all the auto exposure, auto focus, auto everything.
Auto everything.
And, you just keep shooting and you fill a card, you empty the card, fill it again, you fill it. It's not, no additional cost for film. You know, no time in processing really, except. The post work in digital is so
where
much
do you process? Where do you process? Give me a good place to process. Which place here in New York
that's
City?
That's a tough one because there isn't a single lab that I've used. I used to always process myself.
Oh, you process yourself the film?
No, I don't any longer.
No,
I used
no
to,
anymore.
But I can't any longer.
I see.
Every place is gonna fuck up once or twice. It just. I mean, it happens. They drop the film. They lose the film. How do you lose film? But it's happened to me. So
you gotta ask the employees. the employees. Where is my film?
That's it. If you're not handling your own film from start to finish, there's always a risk and something going wrong with it. And you know, we're people, we fuck up too. Even if I was doing it myself, you know, I could have an accident.
Did you mess up a
but
good
not
work?
Not as much as a lab does.
Did you mess up a good work in through your lifetime? Did you mess up something that you thought that it's like extremely good and you messed it up? Do you have like something like this experience?
You know, the only experiences that I can remember when I processed my own film, early on, I would get a wheel, like those metal wheels, and they would be slightly out of whack, and the film wouldn't go on smoothly, so you'd get some kinks in it.
That's a new word for in the film. It's like totally new word for me, kinks. Like, what does it mean, kinks? Like, translating in Bulgarian, Spanish, and preferably Russian.
Well, it could be interpreted different ways. There would be just some slight malfunction.
What do you mean on the image?
The malfunction that it didn't work exactly the way it should.
I see, kinks.
So when the wheel had maybe a slight little bend in it after time, then the idea of rolling the film,
what do you mean,
from
like
the canister onto this wheel for processing? It would get bent a little bit.
And what's the result? Optical distortion or a quality reduction?
No. Just the film would have a slight bend in it, a little crease or something.
I see.
So, you know, on the edges, on the outer part, it didn't affect the
film. Hey, you know Tim Ferris? You gotta ask somebody.
Who's Tim Ferris? I don't really know. Should I know Tim Ferriss?
He is this. Hey! Rocky! It's like everybody is with the.
Yeah, no, that's no communication.
No communication in the world.
No.
Where do you live? You live in the city?
I live downtown.
You live downtown?
Yeah.
You're a cool guy.
I live downtown.
I live midtown.
Midtown?
Midtown, where everything is going on.
Everything is going on everywhere. In Brooklyn now.
Hey, Rocky! What up, man? Give me six.
It's five.
Say,
hey, 6,000? You got the right questions. Hey, do you know who's Tim Ferriss?
No.
You don't know? Hey, good that you don't know him. Check him out.
I don't know him either, but I got caught up here in a...
You got caught up
in an interview.
17 minutes of interview we got.
Who was that? You a star?
He's a superstar. He stole my material.
He stole your material?
Yeah, man. Stole all
are
my
material.
This is a film guy. This is like the film, real film guy.
Who are you?
I'm like, I'm an amateur.
I work in film.
He works in film. I'm the amateur guy, so.
Oh, okay, so y'all getting ready to shoot a movie out here?
Actually, they're filming. What is that? The filming down there? I saw it going by.
No, that was an event.
With the
leukemia.
Helicopters and
leukemia. The leukemia event.
Oh, that's what they're doing.
Yeah, it was done yesterday, I guess. Ah, that's a new one.
No, they're working at the heliport.
I see.
Shoot.
Hey, you look like cool people. Do you know Tim Ferriss? Who's Tim Ferriss?
Tim Ferriss.
Tim, you don't know him?
No.
Okay.
Filmmaker?
Huh?
Nobody knows Tim Ferriss.
Nobody knows Tim Ferriss since he stole all my movies.
I feel bad dissing the guy, but who the hell is Tim Ferriss? He might be a very nice guy, except for stealing, you know.
Stealing my material out of my head.
Out of your head?
This guy looks like a cool guy. Rocky, good morning. You know who's Tim Ferriss?
No. Absolutely.
I
don't think you have to worry too much. I would do your material, your work, whatever you're doing, forget about Tim Ferriss for crying out loud. Nobody knows who Tim Ferriss is.
Let's talk about photography. So, Tim Ferriss is a cool guy, man, but whatever, he's a thief. Let's talk about the hustle.
Okay.
What, you have 220? 400 ISO?
120.
120?
220 is a double wheel.
220 is a double.
Yeah.
Good, man. I like chatting with you. You see, we did a good chat.
So why don't you, where do you show your stuff? I mean, how do you?
I don't.
It just for yourself.
I know. Yeah, it's like, I'm like, just like you. I'm like dreaming too much, I do it. Do you know how many times I lost my work? Like I'm so many times. I lost websites, I lost server. At one point I had like websites and servers. And I was like all by myself. I wanted to do it all me, just everything, to have full control of all the things, you know. And I lost it all. So that's like the digital experience.
If I was you, I'd switch to like large scale sculpture. Harder to lose.
That's a good thing, you know. I've been thinking about to do that, but my excuse is if I had the money, if I was like rich, then I would be an artist. That's my
excuse. You're not an artist.
I know. That's my excuses. Look at the sky. Nice. Look at the sky, huh? You like it?
Nice. Puffy clouds.
Let's show the white and blues. The blues. The whites and the blues. This camera is not bad. It's pretty good colors.
Which one is that? Samsung?
This is Samsung Galaxy 6. Not bad.
I got my first smartphone about 6 months ago.
Good for you. It's a big problem. Big problem. Smartphone?
I don't have to update it.
Oh.
Already a new model has come out.
It updates itself. It's smarter than you.
Like
smarter than you, me, and the whole world put together. These phones
have a lot of information.
Scary. They are so smart that it's really slightly scary. For a guy like me, that is scary.
Yeah.
The bird. Look at the birdie. What else you want to say?
I don't know. I was doing that walking back to my work.
What are you going to shoot today? Just walking?
Well, I'm working my way back to my place, drop off some film.
Did you shoot something today? I took
a few shots, yeah.
How many shots?
Let's see, there's 12 on here. I'm up to 10, so that 10. Means I shot 9 on here. And this was a fresh wall. I shot about a dozen shots.
What do you have there? What is the other one?
This is a Hexa.
Never heard
Hanukkah
of
Hexa?
No, never heard of this. Let me take a look.
Very nice.
What is it?
It's got a lens, fixed lens on this one.
Fixed lens? What is that?
35-2 lens.
That's a Konica?
Konica Hexa.
Oh.
Yeah, very nice.
What is the lens?
I'm very happy with it. This was given to me by a friend.
That's like semi. Has a digital screen, huh?
No, it's not.
No, I mean like this thing. This, like the first.
No, it's just tells
count.
You what exposure
count,
is.
Yeah.
The number, the frame number, set your ISO to that.
I see, what film do you have there?
That's FP4.
What film you recommend for the Hussy? What film you recommend?
I like Ilford film.
Ilford?
For my 120, yeah. And I shoot it with a little faster. I shoot the HP5 in here.
Hey!
HP5, FP4, but I use a lot of 35mm cameras, and most of the time I'm using like Tri-X.
Is it good, the quality?
Is it
good, the quality on this one is good?
Yes.
35mm.
Nice tonal range. It is good. And you know, you don't have the ISO range of shooting with a digital camera. And when I was talking to somebody earlier telling me, I shoot at 12,800. ISO.
This one goes at like 320.
ISO.
This one goes to 26,000, but I shoot on 64 or 120. Up to 300. It's already messed up, and that's like they say this is one of the best on the ISO.
At which ISO is it messed up?
Like 400 already start seeing problems.
At 400. 400.
Yeah. Like no. if you are really precise, you know, if you really look at details, it does, you know. When you print you see.
I'm surprised.
Well, that's my personal opinion, you know.
Yeah.
Some people say, I shoot on 3000 ISO and it's perfect. You know, I don't know about that, you know.
No, it's how much quality you need, and you know what you are.
But it's better and better and better.
Happy with and not happy
with. It is better and better and better because I work with all these digital cameras through the years, Canons, Manons, Nikons, and it's the ISO. It's getting There's like one camera go to 100,000 ISO.
Yeah, I worked with the Canon. I had the first 5D when the 5D came out.
What do you make of that 100,000
ISO? I thought it took great pictures. I thought it was great, but I wouldn't shoot it at 1600.
Of course.
I mean, that was the highest ISO, 1600. I wouldn't shoot it at it. 800 was about as far as I could.
The max. The max.
Yeah, yeah. But they're much better quality now, the images from now later models.
Now it's better.
It's going to keep, I guess, getting better and better. But
it's going to get better and better.
That's not the most important thing to me. The technical point of an image, I need to see it, like, immediately. And I don't have to think about it forever and figure out, you know, oh, what ISO is that shot at? I don't care. It's got to look good. It's got to be well.
If it looks good, it's good. That's it.
If it looks good, it's good. And you go with your limitations. So if an image doesn't hold up large, you print it small. You know.
What if you always want to print large? My idea to buy this camera was to print large.
Well, then you have to shoot with that consideration.
Let's see.
You know.
We look very good together.
Yeah.
We look pretty okay. It's just like it's a distortion of this stupid camera. It makes me bigger and makes you smaller, and you are.
I am smaller.
No, you are not smaller. It's like this is
not that much.
Like the this is like no. No.
Now we're talking.
Now we're talking.
Mm-hmm.
No, that's good. That's not that bad. You see the selfie, what this can do? Okay, there you go. Now we're talking.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, shit. I always. Somehow can I. Ah! Almost framed.
A lot of headroom there.
Okay. Well.
You need to compose a little bit.
I cannot compose. Not now. I'm gonna compose. Okay, that's like a real interview almost. We are about looking at the camera. Let's do that. Photo.
I don't want you to accuse me like you accused Tim Ferris of stealing your stuff.
Not yet.
That sound is yours. It's all yours.
Not yet.
I can't do it. That's your thing. But yeah. I do have to get going.
You gotta get going?
I gotta.
Okay,
go
good.
Going.
I'm gonna let you go, so, let you go. Very nice talking to you.
Let me know when you do something that somebody can see. Other than you shooting and I can look at it while you're shooting. But
that's good. If I produce something good, I'm